The attack yesterday on the Hawaiian Islands has caused severe damage to American naval and military forces.
After the war, a lot of the guys back from the war, they didn't have jobs and they didn't really have they didn't know whether they'd be coming back or not, you know, so they didn't really have anything planned. And so they played baseball.
And play ball they did. In the mid-1950s, about a decade after the Second World War had ended, men had come back from the war with no prospects except for baseball. While most only know Hot Springs as a hub for baseball in Arkansas, Johnson County has a rich history of baseball that most are unaware of. Nowadays, most people think of professional and college baseball. However, in the mid-1950s, Clarksville had one of the hottest teams in Northwest Arkansas.
What they call the Arkansas Valley League is a semi-pro league. It included, Clarksville, Marlton, Russellville, Danville, and old teams like that, Paris. And I had played in Fort Smith until our league closed up in late July.
And you know what? Television run the baseball because people sit home and not got to go out. But when we was playing those good teams, we played up at the city park. And that thing, you couldn't even get in. You couldn't even get a parking place or get a place to sit. It's so many people.
Had big wooden bleachers that were tore down just a few years ago, and now they've got just the aluminum bleachers there, but everybody probably remembers those. And when they played, those would be pretty much full, and people all down the third base and first base side watching the game. So it was pretty popular at that time.
They'd come out and see good baseball, and I don't care what you had for now, you wouldn't get many out. They'd rather stay at home and watch television.
Players like David Ross and Ted Young thrived in the Arkansas River Valley League. What made the league special, and what makes baseball special, is that it's a timeless sport, something that can be related to throughout generations.
One time we played here in Clarksville in 57 and 58, we played the state semi-pro championship tournament for the state. And I had pitched 8 innings, it was a hot July day. And I'd pitched 8 innings and I went in, and we were up 3-2. And I went up and told the manager of the team that you better get the guy ready because I didn't think I could go. I'd about burn out. I wasn't as good a shape as I had been because when I was playing all the time. But anyway, he sent me back out in my 9th inning. And I don't know, the first guy got on, I don't know where I walked him or he got a hit or whatever, but the next guy sacrificed. Well, I fielded the ball, and I had the guy dead at second. Cramp hit me in the rear, and I threw the ball in the center field, and then I did walk the next man, load the bases, nobody out. So, boy, he goes out and gets me out and brings in the relief guy, and he, first guy hits a one-hopper back at him, and he throws home at first, double play, and the next guy pops up, so we win the championship 3-2. Back then, when you win your state championship, you went to Wichita to play in the national semi-pro tournament.
Even after his time as a player, baseball still had a hold on David Ross.
And in 1959, I was athletic trainer. I couldn't, I'd signed pro contract, so I wasn't eligible to play any sports, you know. So I was the athletic trainer, and he asked me if I'd like to help him coach the baseball team.
In 1973, David Ross began coaching at Clarksville High School. And between the years of 1973 and 1991, when he retired, Coach Ross had gone to the playoffs a handful of times, too many times to recall, in fact. However, 1988 is a year that David Ross will always remember, because in 88, he had won the state championship.
Oh, he did a good job coaching too, because the field was named after him.
However, David Ross wasn't the only one in the Clarksville baseball community that had an impact that lasted decades.
Of course, Lonnie's really a good athlete, but he wouldn't play baseball or anything with us, or basketball.
Well, when you play that many sports, I really got tired of traveling, and so our traveling wasn't the most convenient. We went in the, of course, we had a bus for football, but the other times we either had a van or we had a big old extended Plymouth that would hold 10 or 12, and so we looked like a tribe of gypsies when we were going to games and stuff.
Similar to David Ross, Lonnie Qualls decided he wanted to go into coaching. Initially starting off as a football coach, Lonnie Qualls was later put in the role as Ozark's baseball coach. Though he was primarily a football and basketball phenomenon in his time as a player, he found a love in the game of baseball. His multiple decades of service proved him to be a loyal and respectable coach among other athletes and coaches. And near the end of his service as a coach, the university decided to honor Coach Qualls by naming the field after him.
Well, it was a real big, important day. I didn't do a very good job of expressing my thanks or anything that day, but they really put on a special day for me.
But Fritz Aaron's in there. He's a former assistant football coach at the CFO, and the head baseball coach. And later on, he became president of the college. So he was president of the college for a while.
Examples like Fritz Aaron, Lonnie Qualls, and David Ross show that baseball is more than just a game. It's a way to make lifelong connections with others and give back. After Fritz Aaron stepped down as president in 91, there were still stories to come about baseball. In the mid-90s, the University of the Ozarks went from an NAIA athletic school to an NCAA Division III. With this change came some new opponents for Ozarks in further states than they've played before. With the new itinerary came some interesting stories from the road.
Ours was terrible. My last year we went to Sol Ross in vans. They didn't chart us. We got a van. We had three vans. I had to drive half the way. Yeah, but I can remember my first spring break trip that we had. It was two vans, 15 passenger vans. And we went to Tennessee, Louisiana, and Mississippi. Because we'd show up and, you know, play a doubleheader, come back to hotel, come back and play a doubleheader. We were just done. We were ready to be done.
Well, I guess one of the things, if a guy's gonna do anything, he needs to put the whole thing in it.
If you do things correctly in basketball, it's gonna be in your favor. Football's the same way. But in baseball, you can do it correctly and still you still won't succeed.
The mechanics of it, having a pitching coach and those, and I think that was my weakest area as a pitching coach.
The only encouragement that I had, and I'll give you what Coach Hart always said, is the moment you step on the field, give all you got. Don't ever look at yourself. And he used to talk to us about, you know, when you get done playing, these 4 years, after that fourth year, don't ever look in the mirror and say, man, I could have did this, or I could have done that. Always give everything you got.